let us discuss now dry corrosion. So dry corrosion, why it takes place? Dry corrosion takes place due to the direct attack of atmospheric gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, sulfur, moisture, chlorine and many other gases. When these gases attack on the metal surface, the corrosion takes place. So how the direct attack of gases takes place, we'll see with the example of oxygen. So we'll see only the mechanism of corrosion by oxygen here. Okay, so what is the mechanism of corrosion by oxygen? We'll see there are four steps involved in the mechanism. First is the adsorption of O2 molecule on the surface of metal. So parallel you will also see in the diagram, so how the O2 molecule will come in a contact with the metal and it will get adsorbed on the surface of metal. So adsorption of O2 molecule on the surface of metal is the first step. What is the second step? Dissociation of O2 molecule into atoms. So here we'll see in the diagram, O2 molecule which is adsorbed on the surface will get dissociated into oxygen atom. After the formation of oxygen atom on the surface of metal, there is a loss of electron by metal atom to oxygen atom. So metal atom will transfer electron from metal to oxygen and there is a formation of positively charged metal ion and negatively charged oxygen ion. So third step is a loss of electron by metal atom to oxygen atom and there is a formation of ions, metal ion cation and oxygen anion. Finally, there is a formation of metal oxide by the union of these ions. So how this positively charged metal and negatively charged oxygen ion finally combines and there is a formation of thin metal oxide. So that is a formation of metal oxide. Now we'll see the mechanism of corrosion by oxygen. What actually happening here, metal is there, metal generally loses the electron. So after loss of electron by the metal atom, it forms a positively charged metal ions and oxygen will take that electron and there is a formation of negatively charged anion of oxygen. So the number of electrons here in both the cases will get cancelled as there are same number of electrons are involved. Okay, so what will be the overall reaction? 2 metal plus N by 2 O2 gives 2 Mn plus NO minus man. But there is a union or a combination of metal ion and oxide ion and that's why there is a formation of metal oxide. This is the complete mechanism of dry corrosion. So as now we have discussed the mechanism of dry corrosion, in the last step of the mechanism of dry corrosion, there is a formation of oxide film. So there are generally four types of oxide film formed in the mechanism we have seen. So we will see the one by one. Porous film can form, non-porous film can form, unstable oxide film can form and oxide, volatile oxide film can also form. So we'll see the first porous oxide film. So if the film form is a porous, so suppose this is the oxide film form, this is the oxide film form and if this oxide film is porous in nature, further corrosion takes place. As this oxide film is porous, there are pores and through the pores oxygen gets penetrated and further corrosion takes place and in this way whole metal gets destructed. So what are the examples which metals are generally forms a porous film? So iron, steel, magnesium, sodium, potassium, calcium, these are porous oxide films generally. So examples are given here, sodium and magnesium. When sodium forms oxide, sodium oxide, magnesium forms the magnesium oxide, these type of oxides are porous in nature. The corrosion continues and the whole metal get destructed. The second type of oxide film is non-porous oxide film. So in case of non-porous oxide film, that is generally stable, non-porous, strong and well adhered. So what happens if this is the metal and this is the oxide film form? If it is a strong, this oxide film is strong, non-porous, well adhered, further corrosion cannot be possible, and that's why metal get protected here. Which metals are generally forming this type of oxide film? Chromium, tin, zinc, lead, nickel, copper, and many more. These are the some of the examples given here. They are generally forming non-porous oxide film. Third type of oxide film is unstable oxide film. When oxide film form is unstable, it decomposes back into the metal and oxygen, so no corrosion takes place there. Example is gold, platinum, and silver. In case of gold, platinum, and silver, when it combines with the oxygen, there is a formation of metal oxide. But this metal oxide decomposes back into the metal and oxygen once again, and that's why there is a no corrosion takes place, as there is a no formation of oxide. And the last type of oxide film is volatile oxide film. In case of volatile oxide film, if the oxide form here is volatile, what happens in case of volatile oxide film? Here, this is the volatile oxide film. This gets evaporated, and due to the evaporation of volatile oxide film, the metal, fresh metal, get exposed, and further corrosion takes place. But the speed of evaporation is very slow. What is the example of volatile oxide film? Molybdenum is the best example of volatile oxide film. Molybdenum generally combines with oxygen, formation of volatile molybdenum oxide.